Oregon Football 89 is made possible by Harold Taylor, Taylor Electric Supply, Portland. Immer and Oswald, Volvo and Subaru, Gladstone. Mashofsky Lumber Company, Portland. And by the Oregon Club of Portland.
Hello, everybody. I'm Todd McKim, along with the coach, and welcome to this week's show as we take a look back at that great victory over the Hawkeyes of Iowa back in Big Ten country. We'll hear from some of the players about that victory and also take a preview look at what's in store next week as the Ducks take on the Stanford Cardinal. Congratulations, coach. That was a super win. I don't know, especially in that first half and probably the first portion of the third quarter, that your team has played a better football game from the offensive, defensive, and special team standpoint.
Well, you can go back a couple of years, maybe that SC game when we opened up so well in the first quarter particularly. I think that the disappointing thing is we had several opportunities in that first half that we didn't take advantage of. An interception down near the end zone, a fumble down deep before the half. We had a chance to really put the icing on the cake early and made too many mistakes to capitalize on those great field position opportunities.
You guys are never satisfied. You were leading 24-0 at halftime, but you're right. You probably could have scored maybe 60 points in this game just the way things went. The one thing that everybody talked about after the game was speed and quickness, the fact that you guys had a tremendous advantage over Iowa in that particular phase of the game.
Well, it was very evident on the line of scrimmage, particularly our defensive front against their offensive line. I think that the quickness was definitely a factor. Our skill people, running backs, receivers, catching the ball on the perimeter of the Hawkeye defense also was very significant. And I've always said I'd rather take quickness. I'd like to have a big, quick guy, but I don't want a big, slow guy.
The Ducks won the toss of the coin and elected to defer their decision until the second half. So the Hawkeyes will get the football to start the game. Let's go back out to Kinnick Stadium and set the starting lineups. A sellout crowd of 67,700, 53rd consecutive sellout for Iowa football. Defensive front, the same trio that started against California, Labonte, Cusano, and Williams. Linebacking core, Jensen Kearns, Farwell, and Brantley back in there. And in the defensive secondary, look at those crazy guys. Oldham, Derry, Horton, and Reed. Offensively for Iowa, it's a big offensive front. We have already mentioned Anderson, Poynton, a very strong offensive guard. Watkins, the split end. And in the backfield, Bass, 222 pounds. Bell, 255. Hughes, and then the tight end is Palmer. Ideal playing conditions. This is regular grass, prescription athletic turf, they call it, just installed this year. Cost them about $1 million. And you can see right off the bat, a fumble, but recovered by Iowa. And the Hawkeyes start deep in their own territory. Big play right off the bat.
Here we go on a stunt. Labonte comes inside, penetrates. They don't block him, and he kisses Bell right in the... He rings his bell, as a matter of fact.
He did ring his bell. You came up with that tease line, I might add, too. So if anybody wants to call in and question these tease lines, so you're great about that one to Coach Brooks. Anyway, defensive play of the game this week, and tell us what happened, because I thought it set the tempo for the game.
Well, I'm a little bit surprised we were allowed to make this kind of penetration here, because we do a lot of slanting with our line, and we're in a stunt where we're bringing our weak side linebacker on a pinch move, bringing our weak side end on a pinch move underneath, moving our nose strong side. They pass set the tackle, a play that Cal used, and tried to run a kind of a delayed blast draw on us. They pass set this man, and of course Labonte just came right underneath him and hit Bell just about the time he got the handoff. But at the same time, Andre Williams has taken this tackle, who's pass setting clear back, and comes right off and gets in on the tackle right behind Labonte. And that, I think, set the tone for our defense for the whole day. We were beating them to the punch most of the time, getting penetration into their backfield, hitting their plays before they could establish any movement at all.
All right, let's take a look at this downstairs on our reverse angle camera. Labonte will be to the right.
See the tackle pass set here. Labonte goes underneath. Tackle comes out on Bjarne Jensen, but Labonte just kisses him and gets some help there from Andre Williams.
Now, I might add that Bell got up rather dazed after this one. He was kind of staggering around, and nevertheless, they decided to go back to him on the next play.
I thought he was going to our huddle for a minute there. They run the toss sweep here, and here comes Joe Farwell off the weak side linebacker position, makes a tackle for another loss. Joe's played extremely well for a redshirt freshman. You can see him at the bottom of your screen. Cassano now, we're slanting back toward the field here, and Farwell just comes underneath the center trying to block him there and makes the tackle in the backfield.
Farwell, about 205 pounds these days, tackling somebody 50 pounds more than him, but he did a great job, and that's that speed and quickness getting to the punch.
Here they run a conservative trap play on third and long, and they do get a few yards on it, but we stop them short of the first down, forcing them to punt.
So you take over now. First Oregon offensive possession of the game. Musgrave rolls left against the grain to Obi, who did not catch a pass last week, snapped his string of 23 straight games, but he got one. He got five, as a matter of fact, in this game.
Nice throw and a great catch there, and here we come back with Lavelle up the middle for about a four-yard gain.
So the Ducks with a second down and five.
Play action fake there to Lavelle. We hit Barry. This is something we decided early in the week we could do against Iowa because they like to bring five. We tried to get the ball quickly to our backs in the flat, and it worked there. And here Musgrave goes on third down after, I think, a very questionable call. It wasn't called on pass interference. He goes to Tony Hargain off the play action fake here, and you see this on the replay. Fake to Lavelle. Good pass protection. Kunzman on the bottom here getting Musgrave time, and Hargain doing a great job on this post corner route. Same one he caught for a touchdown last week against Cal.
That's exactly right. So Tony Hargain from Bill Musgrave, and the point after by Greg McCallum is good, and the Ducks have an early 7-0 lead.
McCallum has just been automatic. Just really doing an outstanding job kicking the ball.
So the Hawkeyes get it back. This is a second and seven play here. There's screen to Bell, but you can see good pursuit by the defense.
Good pursuit, and it's pretty hard to bring down a 255-pound guy with arm tackles, but we finally got him down there. Andre Williams has played better in this football game. His strength and quickness showed up, particularly against the rush of Iowa here. You can see a nice play there by Andre Williams, getting help from Brantley and Darrell Reed. But Andre did a good job. Watch him on the bottom of your screen. He and Brantley, Andre will take the man. Now he disappears, but you'll see him come in like a shot right here. Boom! Hitting Bell, the 255-pound back. And it's kind of nice to see those big backs go backwards when they get tackled.
So the Hawkeyes forced to punt the football after failing on third and short. Good job, I thought, by your punt return unit yesterday. They did a nice job.
We did a good job. I think we could have done better, but we did help ourselves in field position. Nice return there by Terry Obi.
Unable to move it, and so Iowa gets the football back in Oregon territory for one of the few times in the first half. Pajolski throws it, and Derek Horton picks it off, his second interception of the year.
Nice return. That was their only penetration across the 50-yard line in the first half, and you can see Pajolski drops back to throw here. We have a pressure, but not a great pass rush. We did shrink the pocket, but Horton makes a great break on the ball, jumps in front of the Iowa receiver and makes the interception, uses good vision and running ability here, gets a good block from LeBounty right there, and we get good field position again.
We've got the football at the Iowa 46-yard line. This is a third down and 10. And for one of the few times, Musgrave sacked.
We were sacked twice in this game. Both of them came in the first quarter, and that was the second one.
So now Iowa gets it back. You were talking about trying to capitalize on turnovers. Unable to do it there, but the defense, boy, comes right in, and again, Matt LeBounty and Williams.
Well, he handed off deep in the backfield, and you can see we've got more people back there than they do. There's Bjarne Jensen, LeBounty, Kearns, Andre Williams. This is our whole defensive front. They're 3 yards in their backfield.
Third down and 13. The draw play, Bell.
Missed a tackle in the backfield, but a nice job there by Kyle Kozak coming up and making the play. Fumbled the ball, he knocked him loose, and Matt LeBounty came up with it.
And see, also, Steve Kemp gets a good hit here, might have jarred the ball loose.
Came in after Kyle did, you're right. Both Kyle and Kemp make the hit. and Labounty comes up with the fumble recovery. Labounty had a fine football game for a young sophomore.
Very good player. So the Ducks capitalize this time, or try to, I should say. Musgrave throws it, and I know he'd like to have that one back. It's probably as soon as he threw it, as Merton Hanks made the interception for Iowa.
Nice play by the Iowa defender, but an ill-advised throw by Bill Musgrave.
So it's 7-0. Oregon has dominated the first play, leads by a touchdown. Once we pick up play with Iowa having the football, this is a 3rd and 2, and again, the defense is there.
Kind of nice to see that white jersey swarm over there, isn't it? Great play here by Bjarne Jensen on the bottom. Takes that tight end, stuffs him, takes the fullback, spins out, forces him. Chris Oldham's there to make the tackle. Gets help from Joe Farwell, Roy Derry, Mark Kearns, and Peter Brantley.
5 white jerseys in on the tackle. So Obi again to go back to receive the punt. He averaged 10 yards per return a week ago. Had a little better average this week.
Almost blocked by Johnny Taylor. He's going to get some before the year's over. Little wiggle there by Obi. Picks up about a 14-yard return and gives us our offense great field position. Hand off to Lattenberry right up the middle. A play that worked successfully last week against Cal. Good blocking at the point of attack by the offensive line. And we come right back with another one up the middle to Berry. And we penetrate deep into Iowa territory.
So, another first down. The next play we see will be 2nd and 11. This is a great throw by Bill Musgrave.
Perfect pass right over Obi's shoulder. And you'll see that Musgrave is under pressure when he throws this ball. People right in his face, throws it up over, nice catch. Almost got in there. Terry had a big day, but he didn't get in that end zone. You can tell right there he wanted it pretty badly.
So on 1st and goal from the 1, Lattenberry, his first touchdown of the season into the end zone. And the Ducks march down the field and score their 2nd touchdown. The Oregon fans that were there were making more noise than the 67,500 Iowa fans.
They had quite a supportive group there.
It was a good group.
Gave them something to yell about, too. Yeah,
they had fun, that's for sure. So it's 14-0. We're early in the second quarter. Again, they try to toss sweep. And again, tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Great job by Roy Derry coming up and supporting the sweep. You can see that he'll come up here, take on the fullback, get his piece of the tackle. Chris Leupold in there also penetrating into the backfield and getting some help from his teammates.
Loss of 2 on the play. So the Hawkeyes forced to punt again. You get great field position on a very poor punt. You come right back at him.
Back out in the flat to Berry again, trying to get the ball to our backs. Out on the perimeter a little bit to take advantage of our speed and quickness. Musgrave now hands it off to Latin. He takes it up and dips it around the end. Picks up a 1st down.
So the next play we see after the Ducks get it down to the goal line is a 3rd and goal. And Lavelle over the top. I thought he had scored on the previous play, but this one he got in.
We're going to give him 2 touchdowns because he did score the time before. Clearly scored. We came right back with the same play just to make sure that official didn't miss it this time because it was brutal. That's one of the worst calls I've ever seen. His whole body was in the end zone with the ball.
So the Ducks get it into the end zone and now lead it after the PAT 21-0, 6 minutes to play, 2nd quarter. And there were a lot of stunned folks in the stands.
Probably some on the radio and TV too.
There were a few.
Nice pass to Obi on the sprint out by Musgrave coming to the perimeter on a tough throw coming to his left. Drop back here, good protection. Again, a swing pass out into the flat to Lattenberry and a 12-yard gain and another 1st down.
A couple of plays later, the Ducks have a 3rd and 6 at the Iowa 18-yard line. Joe Merton, boy, you've got some good tight ends.
We do, we really do. And Big Joe's playing with some bruised ribs, which he dinged a little bit again, but not as bad as last week. Nice catch here. Look at the power and the strength. Kind of looks like a Big Ten tight end, doesn't he, huh? 6'3", 250.
He's a big, strong young man. And unfortunately, on the play, Scott Boatwright went down with a knee injury.
Colin Hall taking some warm-up snaps on the sideline. South Eugene graduate finished the game out at center and did a very good job.
Lattenberry trying the inside. The ball comes loose, stripped, recovered by Iowa.
Could have been down on that play, very questionable, but certainly a big play for Iowa right before the half. We miss another scoring opportunity, but get it right back after defense does a good job. We throw the ball down the field to Tony Hargain. Get down deep inside the 20,
Time running out in the first half. Ducks leading 21-0, looking for more.
Swing pass again to Lattenberry and get down to about the 7-yard line.
So on fourth and very short, with the time running out in the half, McCallum kicks the field goal, 25-yarder, and you go into the halftime locker room with a 24-0 lead over Iowa. Well, we're ready to start the third quarter. Ducks leading 24-0. Kind of good news and bad news in this third quarter as we see the Ducks on offense in the third period of play. The second offensive play of the quarter, Lattenberry gets back to the line of scrimmage and gets hurt.
Bent over backwards, medial collateral partial tear. Right now the word is 3 to 4 weeks, and he should be able to return. Very fortunate. Last night we weren't too sure that it wasn't more serious than that. Terry Obey, nice catch as we started the first play of the game on offense. We come out first play in the second half, sprint out and hit Terry Obey. Nice catch, goes up and makes it. Gets hit as he comes down, hangs onto the football. We pick up a big first down on the very first play.
Terry with 126 yards on 5 receptions against the Hawkeyes.
Little dump pass over the middle to Jeff Thomason. Falls forward for about a 4 or 5 yard gain.
This is a third down play and just a tremendous effort by Derek Lavelle to get the first down.
Great run. Not a lot of running room, mostly on his own. We don't do a very good job. No hole inside, so he bounces it outside, shakes a couple tackles, shows great presence here as where the sideline is and where the first down marker is, and lunges forward and gets it by about a yard.
I've always said that some of the best runs you'll ever see will be by Derek Lavelle when he only gets 5 or 6 yards. He just has a great knack for getting upfield.
Andre Bosley now in the game, replacing Lattenberry at fullback. Same pass in the flat we've been hitting Latten with earlier. Now the screen pass back to Lavelle. Good block out there. And Lavelle spins forward for another first down.
So we'll take another look at that one. Great to block by Kurt Dykes out here.
Kurt Dykes.
Oops, this is not the replay. This is the next play.
Next play, Bosley again on the swing pass up there for a 12-yard gain and a first down. Moving those chains.
The redshirt freshman, Calamini, in there.
Malu has really had a good fall camp, and you're going to see him do some good things. He's a good football player. On the counter play here, excellent block at the point of attack. Calamini cuts it back. Big back, 6'1", 214, 15 pounds. Good moves. Takes it down deep into Iowa territory.
First and goal from the Hawkeye 4-yard line.
Fake the play action inside. Great job by Kolya Teft at the back of the end zone, going up and getting down in bounds for the touchdown. You can see Kolya Teft releasing, going across. Musgrave just throws it up over the Iowa defender, and Cole makes a great catch for the touchdown. You know, last week it was Jeff Thomason that got the touchdown. Now Cole came back with two. We've got to get Merton in that end zone now off that tight end package.
Of course, he had bruised his ribs on that drive. I think it was on the first maybe play of the drive, and came out of the football game. And come back with a little counter, and boy, Andre Williams right there.
Quickness again in the backfield just before they get the handoff. Watching the bottom of your screen, gets right in the hip of the tackle, hits the back in the backfield for a 5-yard loss. Great play by Andre. Good quickness and penetration.
Stewart is now the back in there. Tony Stewart rushed for 1,000 yards last year, but had a knee injury, replaces Bell. Boholski trying to roll out. This is, I believe, a third down play. Mark Kearns, the man we talked about, made the stop.
Pressured and forced him out of the pocket. Kearns comes up and makes the stop short of a first down.
So the Ducks again get it back. Second offensive possession, third period.
Speed, here we see it.
And you got a break here because I believe this might have been a fumble recovered by Iowa, but.
They said it was down. That's one of the few breaks we did get in the game. Most of them we earned. Terry hurt his elbow on the play, but you can see the speed and acceleration here. Nice throw by Musgrave on the curl route. Puts a little zip on it. Obey turns on the third gear here and then shifts again after he makes a cutback right there. Boom. But he'll get blindsided from the back. And this really clearly is, I believe, a fumble. Ball is out before he hits the ground, but it was ruled otherwise to our good fortune.
Indeed. But to take advantage of the situation, third and goal from the 5. Musgrave steps up in the pocket. There he is again. Poljotev.
Good pass protection, a good pocket for Musgrave to step up in, and just before I think he decided he was going to run it, he saw Cole open between the linebackers and just kind of flipped it to him. You can see him step up here. He's starting to run, and he sees him and flips it, and Cole goes up and makes a nice catch for his second touchdown in the third quarter.
So the point after is also good. The Ducks leading at 38-0 with 6:18 to play in the third period. Another big play by the defense. Poholski trying to go across the grain, underthrows the pass, and there's Derek Horton with his second interception of the game, third of the year.
Horton does a good job playing center field back there. You can see a sprint out here. We lose contain. I'm glad he didn't pull it down and keep running because we didn't have anybody out there. We finally do pressure somebody up into his face a little bit. Badly underthrown pass. Horton played it very well. Not quite as good a return here as his first one.
Still managed to get 18 on the return, and again, pretty good field position to start things off. Bill Musgrave now on the sidelines. Bobby Brothers in at quarterback.
Draw play to Dondre Bosley, finds a big hole, accelerates into the Iowa secondary. Straight arm, 34-yard run. Very nice play by Dondre.
Take another look at that one.
See on the left side of our line, good blocking. Over there, Sunia gets a good block, and Dondre just turns on the speed. Iowa player had an angle on him and knocked him out of bounds in front of our bench.
So the ball now in Hawkeye territory at the 49, first and 10.
Counter play here to Lavelle. Pick up another first down. Nice run there by Derek on the counter play.
So first and 10 at the Hawkeye 35. Try the option and mistake.
Mishandled the pitch, hit him in the hands with it. And Derek, first time we've run that play this year in the game. We ran it last week in practice quite a bit, but we mishandled it.
Speaking of mishandling, new quarterback Rogers in the ball game for Iowa, and he fumbles the snap. Covered by Dozier. The Ducks leading at 38-0 entering the fourth quarter. Iowa has mounted a drive late in the third period and gets its only score of the afternoon on the first play of the fourth quarter. A fourth and inches. They go with the naked bootleg by Rogers, and he beats Chris Oldham to the end zone.
Fooled everybody, trying to make the big play inside to stop him on fourth down, and they came with a naked boot out around the end, and he walked in easily for the touchdown.
The Ducks unable to move it, but I wanted to mention Mark Penso because he had a good day punting a football yesterday.
Averaged over 45 yards a punt. Really is becoming a very, very good, consistent punter. Bjarne Jensen trying to put pressure on the quarterback here. Mark Kearns Labounty comes from the backside. The second effort knocks him loose from the ball, and Derek Horton recovers for his third takeaway of the game. Two interceptions and a fumble recovery.
So that results in the field goal.
Greg McCallum on the year now is 6 out of 7 on field goals, only missing a narrow one against Cal, 49-yard option play. They return the favor. We fumbled the option. They fumbled the option. Here, Dozier, JC linebacker who couldn't play last week because of a concussion he sustained in a scrimmage before the Cal game, recovers the fumble. Good job, good pursuit by Doug Douglas as well, but Eric Dozier comes up with the football and the takeaway.
A second fumble recovery for Dozier on the day.
Ours was about in the same place on the field. Anthony Jones, nice pass from Pete Nelson. Wanted to let these guys pass a little bit here so we can move the ball and try to run the clock down a little bit. Good pass protection for Nelson. Kelamini steps up, gets a good block on the linebacker who comes in. Anthony Jones, a redshirt freshman from down in L.A., makes a nice catch, and you're going to see a lot of this young man in the future.
In fact, you'll see more of him right here.
Well, this is the future. Watch this little shake and bake here. Boom, leaves him. Got a little acceleration, hangs on to the football. Nice play for another first down.
Take a look at that one down low again.
He's got great feet. Anthony does a good job. You can see him here. He's got excellent feet, and little shake, and he takes it up the field. And at this point, I came over and told him, okay, now we've got the ball down deep. It's late in the game. We'll just keep it on the ground. And unfortunately, we couldn't get a first down and had to settle for another field goal.
Down the heart again by McCallum. This one good from 39 yards out. And we've got one final play to show you. That will be the final score, but Iowa with one final offensive play.
Flash Taylor, very unselfish player, been great on the special teams. He moved over from tailback to corner when we had a problem in depth there, and makes a big play on the last play of the game. I'm really happy for him.
We'll take one more look at that one.
And I hope he can get a chance to get some more of these things, because he has the speed and running ability, obviously being a tailback, that he can do some damage with him. You can see he goes up high. Brady Brooks back there also making a play on the ball, but here comes Taylor. Gets good blocking up there by Kessler out in front, but gets caught from the side.
Told me after the game he just ran out of gas. Clock ran out of time. Fortunately for Iowa, as the Ducks come away with an impressive 44-6 victory. Let's take a look at the final stats team-wise for the ball game. You can see the Ducks with more first downs. Rushing yardage, leading rusher for the Ducks in the ball game was Derek Lavelle with 48, but Dondre Bosley in a reserve role came in with 41. Lattenberry added 30, so good balance. Passing, a little misleading in that Musgrave, 263, 20 of 27, three touchdowns, only one interception, and most of Iowa's passing yardage came in the third and fourth quarters. And total yardage, the Ducks over 400 again for the second week in a row and holding Iowa under 300. Flip the page. One of the key things, obviously, return yardage and the punt returns, and then turnovers. As you see, the Hawkeyes coughed it up four times on fumbles, a couple of more on the interceptions, seven total turnovers, and the Ducks turned it over twice. And very quickly, update on the injuries that you suffered against Iowa.
Well, of course, I mentioned Lattenberry. I think his wasn't as serious. Scott Boatwright will go in for the orthoscopic surgery tomorrow to determine the extent of his injury. And Rick Hunt, unfortunately, sustained a very severely sprained ankle, and he looks like he'll be out for at least 2 to 3 weeks. So we did lose some pretty good football players.
And you got some good ones to replace them, and hopefully they'll be in action against Stanford. We'll see you next week. Same time, same place.